Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, let's try and answer the question of what the difference is between a Dataflow and a Datamart, or which one do I use and why? If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, Dataflows versus Datamarts, and why would I use one versus the other? What's the purpose? Do I even still need a Dataflow? These are all questions that are out there, and I want to kind of walk through what those differences are and why you would use one for the other. First and foremost, yes, there is still a place for Dataflows, and there is a place for Datamarts. There's even a place for datasets, right? So these are all tools in your tool belt that you need to understand in order to use most effectively. And the fact that you're here watching this video tells me that you are wanting to be effective in what you use inside of Power BI, which is great. So I'll also call out Datamarts and Power BI are the new shiny, right? This is the new feature. This was the big announcement at Build 2022. Or if you're not even familiar with what Datamarts are, go check out the video that I did with Patrick exploring Datamarts and Power BI and what it's all about. So I would caution you in just going to the new shiny. Right? So understand the pros and cons, the capabilities, the benefits, the considerations for each of these items, whether it's a data flow, a data mart, a data set, and then make the decision for what the right tool is for that job that you've been tasked to do, the questions you're trying to answer. Now, there could be some cases where maybe it's a mix of all three. Maybe you've got something in your data flow and you want to pull that into your data mart and you're just going to create a new data set as part of it. Those are all considerations that you need to take advantage of. They can be working together. They can be independent. All right, with that, let's look at what are those scenarios where I'm going to use a data flow itself. So a data flow is positioned as a packaged ETL type transformation that you want to do. Think of like a calendar table for your organization. Maybe it's a single dimension. I want to package that in a data flow that can then be reused across my organization. If that's my sole goal, it doesn't make a lot of sense to use a Datamart for that. It absolutely makes more sense to use a data flow. I can use Power Query Online, I can shape it, I can transform it, and then put it out there for other folks to reuse either in their Datamarts or their data sets or both. So maybe it's not your fact tables. We're thinking more of the dimensional, the lookup tables within your organization. Calendar tables one, maybe it's a people or HR table, a hierarchy or your org chart, maybe sales territories or certain groupings that are inside of your organization. Those are great use cases for data flows. Another consideration for data flows too is that data flows allows that capability of leveraging Azure Data Lake storage. So if you do have scenarios where you want to reuse that from a machine learning perspective, data flows enable that type of scenario. Could you do that with Datamarts? Yeah, potentially, but Dataflows was really targeted for that scenario. Another option for Dataflows that could be useful, so as you're creating your Datamart or your data set, some of the Power Query transformations that you're using for a given table or whatnot might be pretty heavy or time consuming. An option you may have is offload that to a Dataflow. You could schedule that at a different time before your Datamart or your data set refreshes to make sure that it's available for when you want to use it. And so now you've got the simplified outcome that you can just pull right in, especially if that particular data that you're processing is going to be reused over and over again. That's a great example of where you may want to use a data flow. When we pivot over to Datamarts, remember Datamarts are really about that self-service database. This is where business users may be blocked by IT. They can't go and create an Azure SQL database or stand up a SQL server on premises. Datamarts empowers them to create that database as part of what they're trying to do. So they get that power of SQL Server and are able to do additional modeling capabilities. I'm not saying you should use this as the quote unquote data warehouse. This is something that you're probably going to work with IT on. It's going to be more centralized and managed. That's not really what Datamarts is for, but it enables the business user to be able to perform their tasks, get their data together. A great option for Datamarts is if you think about it, all those Mac users out there, Power BI Desktop doesn't run on a Mac. They've had to use Parallels or other options to get Desktop to work. Datamarts actually enables some of that modeling capabilities and just give them a web experience for shaping the data with Power Query, pulling it in, creating those relationships, adding some measures, and then creating their reports. And there's that automated data set that's part of that operation. So this may enable your Mac users to do more with Power BI in the web experience and not have to use Power BI Desktop. This is just one part of the journey. So I expect that to improve over time as we get closer to general availability. So just keep your eye on that. Also, like I said, the power of the SQL database is sitting there. So where you may want a SQL endpoint for what you're trying to do, Datamarts enables that for you. Again, without having to go out and create like an Azure SQL database or something of that nature, it's kind of the big brother to Dataflows. Dataflows really target like individual dimensions or individual tables. Datamarts is for that full-fledged, I've got multiple tables. These could be coming from different sources, and I want to bring those together and add relationships and create reports on top of that. Lots of options that are available for you, so just know the benefits of each one before you go and pick something. All right, those are just some of the considerations when thinking about Dataflows versus Datamarts. Did that help you? Is that giving you more information to understand what this is all about inside of Power BI? Let me know down in the comments below. I want to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.